There we go, my pyramid is finished. Hey, Bert, do me a favor. I want to take a picture of this pyramid I built, so while I get my camera, will you make sure nothing happens to the pyramid?
Oh, sure thing, Ernie.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. I just stand here and make sure nothing happens to Ernie's old pyramid.
Greetings. I am the Count.
Hi, Count.
Do you know why they call me the Count? Because I love to count things.
I know.
Ah, look. Blocks. I will count them.
Oh, wait. Those are my friend Ernie's blocks, and he
Silence.
Told me...
I am counting. One, two, three, four. No, I counted that one before. It is difficult to count these blocks in a pile.
Too bad, but you see, Ernie said...
I know what I will do. I will move each block as I count it.
Oh, no. Ernie asked
Silence.
Me to...
One, two, three, four, five, six blocks!
Yes!
Thank you very much.
Oh, boy. Did you see what the Count did? Before I could stop him, he took apart Ernie's pyramid. Oh, boy. I hope Ernie's not upset.
Hello there. I'm ready to take a picture of my... my pyramid.
Yeah.
What happened to it?
He's upset. Ernie, see, the Count was here, and while he counted your blocks, he took your pyramid apart.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
And you let him do it, Bert?
Well...
Greetings. I have decided to count these blocks again.
Now, hold on, Count. Now, these are Ernie's blocks, remember?
Yeah, you just leave those blocks alone.
Yeah,
you're not supposed to touch my blocks.
I am counting. One, two, three, four, five, six blocks. Now, what did you want to say?
Ernie wanted to say that you should leave those blocks alone. You should leave things where you find them. Yeah, that's what he wanted to say.
Oh, did I move his blocks?
Yes, you did.
I am sorry. One, two, three, four, five, six blocks! Thank you very much.
Well, I sure told him a thing or two, didn't I, Ernie?
Yeah, but Bert.
Big Bird somewhere.
Yeah, but he's sleeping.
He's sleeping now? Well, would you like to play a game with me?
Yes!
Oh, I have such a good game. Do you know what we could do?
What?
I will sing London Bridge, and I will be the bridge. And you can crawl under the bridge, okay?
Okay.
Okay, here we go now. Okay. Oh, London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady. Oh, this is so much fun. Oh, London Bridge, falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge, my fair lady. Keep a smile, keep a smile, keep a smile. All day long, just keep a smile. My fair lady. Oh, somebody's tickling me. Oh, 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 oh. I can't sing if you tickle me. Oh, oh, oh dear. London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Do you like to imagine you're somebody else, like a doctor or a pilot or a cowboy?
Yeah. And wouldn't it be fun to be a ship captain or a scientist or an acrobat?
But you know, whenever I get to thinking it'd be nicer to be somebody else, I remind myself how nice it is just to be me. Me. Everything I am is me. Everything I see is me in my mirror, me in my bed. Me in the pictures I make in my head. Me. What a thing to be is me. Utterly delicious. And since there's no choice, I am sure I and me agree. There's nobody better, sweeter, nicer, smarter, don't you see, than me.
You know, sometimes I remind myself how nice it is to be me. But I remind myself in Spanish. Want to hear?
Sure.
Yo, todo lo que es yo. Todo lo que soy es yo. Mi reflejo, yo en el espejo. Yo y lo que pasa en mi cabeza. Yo, lo que quiero ser es yo. Guapo, formidable y tan buen mozo que estarás de acuerdo. No existe nadie más guapo y cariñoso, ya lo ves, que yo.
It's nice being us, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is.
Hey, Oscar. Hmm? What's up?
What do you mean, what's up? The sky is up. You got any other brilliant questions, bright eyes? Look, if you got a lot of questions to ask, you might as well ask this one.
What?
Why don't you ask me if I bought any terrific new hats lately?
Okay. Have you bought any terrific new hats lately?
Odd you should ask. As a matter of fact, I did. I bought a beautiful, terrific hat, the best I've ever seen.
Why, can I?
All us grouches are going to be wearing these hats, going up and down the street.
Well, can I see it?
Well, all right, I suppose. There it is. Look at that.
Hey, that's a dynamite hat.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, you could help put it on if you want.
Okay.
Yeah. How's that?
I thought you said you were going to help put it on.
Well, I am helping you know. What's wrong?
Well, I want to have it lower. That's the way I like to wear it.
Well, why didn't you say that? I'll put it lower then.
That's right. Pull it down.
Okay. How's that? That's good. It's perfect.
Now, lower.
Still lower?
Okay. Right.
All right. Yeah, it's almost over your eyes now. That's fine. Here. How's
no,
that?
It's not fine. Lower.
Oh, Oscar. How's that?
Hey, perfect. Perfect. That's how I like it.
Perfect?
Yeah.
Oscar, if you walk down the street with your hat over your eyes, you're not going to be able to see anybody.
That's right. And I won't see anybody, and you won't see me, and I don't like hearing people, and that includes you.
The girl is on the blanket. The girl is in the blanket. The girl is under the blanket. The girl is on, in, under the blanket. The girl is on, in, under the blanket. On, in. Under.
Tres patas. Cuatro patas. Cinco stingbeans. Ay, no. Una ventana.
Una ventana.
Agua. Mucha agua.
No huevo.
This is Grover, yeah, and today I'm going to talk to you about heavy and light. Yeah, okay, this is a barbell I have in front of me right here, and this barbell is heavy. Now, I will show you how heavy it is. I will try and lift it. Here we go. Once more. Oh, it is heavier than I thought. Try once more. This barbell is heavy! Well, I think that is enough about heavy today, huh? Let us now talk about light, all right? Now, come with me. See over here, this feather? Now, feathers are light, and this feather is light. Here, I will pick it up and show you. See ya? I will pick up this feather. Wait a minute. Why can I not pick up this feather? This feather is supposed to be light. Why is it not light?
Because this feather is attached to me, and I'm heavy.
I give up.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
same color. One, two.
Two turtles.
One, two.
Two heads.
One, two.
Two hats.
One, two.
Two butterflies.
One, two.
Two chocolate cream pies.
I decided to go there anyway. Do it.
Well, what is that?
Greetings, humans.
Who are you?
I am a super automatic machine. You may call me by my initials, S-A-M, Sam.
Sam?
What kind of machine are you?
I am a machine that would be anything you like. What kind of machine do you want? I can do anything. Machines are better than people.
I can't believe this.
I can't even. Look at this.
Machines can do anything. I can be an adding machine, subtracting machine, gumball machine, soda pop dispensing machine, jukebox music.
All right, okay.
Okay, we get the idea. Right.
Yes. And what is more, I never make a mistake. I am a machine, and machines are perfect, are perfect, are perfect, are perfect. Thank you.
What are you doing here on Sesame Street?
You are wrong. This is Mulberry Street. This is not Sesame Street.
No, Sam, I'm sorry. You're wrong. This is Sesame Street.
You are wrong. I am programmed to go to Mulberry Street. I am here. This is Mulberry Street.
You know something, Sam? Maybe you never make mistakes, but you're wrong this time. You goofed, man. This is Sesame Street.
That's right.
I will read out my program again. What street is this?
Look at the lights on.
This isn't a fan down there. There's one over there. Look at the eyes.
Listen to all those noises. Street.
Yes, you see? Well, I have to go, humans. I am meeting a cement mixer for lunch, and machines are never late. They are perfect, are perfect, are perfect, are perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sam?
Yes?
Isn't it a little unusual to meet a cement mixer for lunch?
Yes, it is. Usually, we meet for dinner. I cannot talk any longer. It must be time for me to meet my friend. Please, read out my clock.
Oh, Sam, I can't. It's going forward too fast.
I will make that correction.
Oh, boy, terrific. Now it's going backward too fast.
You see, machines are perfect. We never make a mistake. We are perfect, are perfect, are perfect, are perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, is that the sound of a cement mixer?
Yeah, there's one over there.
Oh, I can stay no longer. I must go. Excuse me. Shirley, wait for me.
What?
I just thought of something terrible.
What's that?
This is Sesame Street.
I know this is Sesame Street.
But he thinks it's Mulberry Street.
So what?
And Shirley the cement mixer is waiting for him on Mulberry Street.
Yeah, so?
Well, he's chasing a perfect stranger.
Danny knows the alphabet, and is he proud? If you can follow him, then sing out loud.
A, B. C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Alphabet! Alphabet! Rah, rah, rah!
And now, it's time for everybody's favorite reunion show, Here Is Your Life. And here is your life host, Guy Smiley.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Here Is Your Life. I'm Guy Smiley, and I'm here in the forest, disguised as a tree, so I can surprise our Here Is Your Life guest. Here I go. Shh. Excuse me. Are you an oak tree?
Why, yes, I am. Who are you? Maple tree? Birch?
No, I'm not a tree at all. I'm Guy Smiley. And oak tree, here is your life.
Oh no.
Yes.
No, you're kidding.
No, we're not me. Yes.
Oh, what a surprise.
Yes, oak tree, you've had a wonderful life. A life that began right here on this very spot. So listen, oak tree, and tell us if you can remember this voice.
I can still remember oak tree when he was just a little acorn.
Oh, no. That's not...
Yes, that's the person who planted you in the ground when you were just an acorn, all the way from the farmhouse down the road, Granny Fanny Nestle Road!
Granny, no. It's so nice.
Tell us, Granny Fanny, was Oak Tree really cute back then?
Well, see for yourself. Here's a picture of him just before I planted him in the ground. He was just an adorable little acorn then.
Aww.
Well, thank you very much, Farmer Fanny.
I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for her.
There's more to your wonderful life. Listen to this voice.
Hi, oak tree. Remember me? I helped you grow.
I know that voice.
Yes, I bet you do, oak tree. And listen to this voice also.
Hi, oak tree. You couldn't have grown without me.
Oh, no. It couldn't be.
Yes, it is. It's the cloud and the sun. Come on out here, cloud.
Oh, my old friend.
Look at that.
Oh, hiya, tree. How you doing?
Oh,
wonderful. Can you tell us, cloud and sun, how did you all help the oak tree to grow?
Well, Guy, I rained on him so he'd have water.
And I shined on him.
Yes. That's right. I couldn't have grown without them.
He remembers.
That's just wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you, Cloud and Sun. Thank you very much for coming out here and being on our stage.
Oh, this is too much.
And so, oak tree, you grew, along with the other trees around you.
Yes.
And you were happy. And then one day, some people came and cut down two of the trees that grew nearby.
Oh, yes.
Those two trees were your friends.
Oh.
You haven't seen them in years.
No.
But we found them. They used to be trees, but now they're a table and a chair. Here they are, all the way from Sausalito, California. Marty Table and Sarah Chair. Come on out here, Marty and Sarah.
Oh, this is
what a wonderful
unbelievable moment.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes. Yes, oak tree, this is it. From little acorn to large, beautiful tree, it's been our pleasure to bring you and your friends together on Here Is Your Life.
Marty, Sarah, oh,
and also, we're going to have for you a beautiful charm bracelet to remember this occasion. There's going to be a party in the forest with all of your friends. There's going to be fertilizer for everyone. The leaves will be there, the bushes from nearby. All the little bitty rabbits.
My old friends, Granny.
Join us again for another visit to
Say, that's a beautiful D you're building there.
Sure is, isn't it? Look at that nice straight back. And how about this curved front here, huh? Fits perfectly to the back. Okay, boys, take it away.
What are you going to do with this D?
Why, this is the D building here. It's full of everything in the world that begins with the letter D. Here, this floor here is the doll floor. They've already moved some dolls in, I see.
Yes, doll begins with D, doesn't it?
And here's the dog floor. Boy, listen to him bark. D-O-G spells dog, all right.
And this must be the floor with diamonds. Aren't they beautiful?
Wow. Hold your ears. Here's the drum floor.
Drum begins with D, too.
And here's where the ducks and dinosaurs and desks will be, on these floors here. Here we are.
Wait. I know a word that begins with D that you forgot to put in your building.
Wanna hear a beautiful sounding word? Warthog. Yeah, warthog. Hehe, warthog. Warthog. Ah, what a beautiful sounding word. And a beautiful animal too. Warthog.
These are the letters U and N. Together they sound like this. Un. Way back there is the letter R. The letter R sounds like this. Un. Run! That's run!
Run! Run!
Hey, look at him run!
Run!
Look at him run! 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 Look at him run!
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 Behind me, there are two doors, here and here. And the letter E is above both of the doors. See him, huh? Do you? All right. I'll bet you're wondering what those two letter E's are doing up there, don't you? Huh? Well, E is a very important letter because it is the first letter in the word enter. And it's the first letter in the word exit. So you see, the letter E is very... That's enough, Roy. Well, kids, that's it. The letter E. Stop it, Roy.
Thank you.
Roy, you're really weird.
Waiter.
Mr. Monster?
Waiter, I'd like to order...
Be patient, one moment. Yes, sir, I'm ready now. What can I do for you?
Yes, I'd like a bowl of chicken soup, please.
Very good choice. You've been here before, haven't you? I'll be right back. One bowl of chicken soup, Charlie!
That settles it. I don't know why I keep coming back to this place. This guy gives me a hard time every time I come in here. If it's not one thing, it's another.
Save me a bowl here, Charlie. Okay, sir. Here we have your delicious chicken soup.
Yes, Waiter!
Yes, sir.
I can't eat this soup.
You can't eat this soup? Why can't... Oh, of course not. I can feel it. It is too cold. I will get you another bowl of soup. I'm sorry, sir. Hey, Charlie, how about a hot bowl this time, okay? Give the guy a break.
Well, that settles it. From now on, I'm bringing my lunch to work in a paper sack.
Okay, Charlie, I think you'll be happy this time. There you are, sir.
Now, I...
Have a good and hearty meal.
Yes, but... Waiter!
Oh, I bet it's too hot now. Okay, I'll blow on for you.
The problem is, you forgot to bring...
Well, I forgot the salt, didn't I? Of course. The pepper.
No.
The crackers.
No.
Well, then tell me, why can't you eat the soup, sir?
Why don't you taste it?
All right, sir. The customer is always right. I shall taste it. Where's the spoon?
Aha!
Oh, I forgot the spoon. Oh!
You can't eat soup without a spoon.
I'm so sorry, sir.
Wow.
There's the spoon.
Now.
Next time, when you want the spoon, ask for one.
What if a frog had a fly's wings and the fly's eyes and the fly's head and the fly's hairy body and the fly's legs? Now then, what if the fly had frog's legs? And a frog's head. And last but not least, a frog's body. What do you think would happen?
Oh, my fair lady. Oh, that was so much fun. Hey, I'm very tired now. I think I better go home. Would you like to walk me to my cave?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Here we go.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letter D and by the number 2. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Whatever that is.
I hope you've enjoyed being taken back in time. I remember the time
when goodbye, Bob.
Goodbye, Bob.